Everybody stand and join me for the call to worship. The invitation is given to every person by Jesus Christ. Come to me, follow me, be my disciples.
We come to this place, to this time, at the invitation of Christ Jesus.
In the name of Christ,
we accept the invitation to discipleship.
In the name of Christ,
as his disciples, we worship and praise God.
In the midst of a world where cruelty abounds, in the midst of despair that threatens to swallow up whole lives,
we proclaim the God of hope.
In the midst of indifference and apathy,
we proclaim the God of love.
Come, let us worship and share God's loving presence in the world.
Of God's love for us and gift of love to us, we often act in destructive and hateful ways. We close our hearts to God and disobey God's law. Together, let us confess our sins. Awesome and compassionate God, you have loved us with unfailing, self-giving mercy, but we have not loved you. You constantly call us, but we do not listen. You ask us to love, but we walk away from the neighbors in need. We condone evil, prejudice, warfare, and greed. God of grace, as you come to us in mercy, we repent in the spirit of truth.
Amen. The God who challenges us is also the God who encourages us. The God who confronts us is also the God who accepts us. Be assured that God is with us even now, accepting, guiding, and forgiving. In Jesus Christ, we pray.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. children to come forward for this morning's baptism. Morning. Glad to see all of you here today as we celebrate a baptism again, celebrate the children of this church and celebrate the families. As we begin the baptism time, let's lead off by singing Jesus Loves Me with the congregation, okay? This is Dash. Say, hey, Dash. He's a little nervous, I think, about me taking away from his family, but let's assure him that he's part of a big family here, and we're all part of his family. Be right back, okay? We're delighted to have a lot of Dash's family and close friends with us today. We celebrate the role that you all play in his development and nurture as well. Let me introduce you to some of the rest of this crowd.
We're popping some here, aren't we?
I'll just hold it for a minute. Yeah. All right. Today we celebrate a covenant. A covenant that God has made with us, that he will never leave us or forsake us, will always be present in our lives. We celebrate that Jesus loves us and Jesus came to this world to give his life for us. We celebrate that children are a gift from God and that we have the opportunity as well as the obligation to nurture them and care for them and raise them in grace of Jesus Christ. So in response to God's covenant love for us today, Dash's parents are presenting him for baptism. They will make some significant promises, as they have for their other children, that they will nurture him and raise him in the faith, have him in Sunday school and teach him about Jesus. We kind of hold him like a football now. We didn't prove to be very good at that in the championship game. Y'all are better, but we know how to hold a football in Alabama. We will have the opportunity as a congregation also to answer some questions that we also will be a part of his Christian nurture. And we'll know him by name. We'll teach him in Sunday school. We'll look after him in the nursery and in youth group. We'll be a part of his family, which is a very significant promise and a blessing. We are blessed in this congregation, as you can see, with many children to nurture and teach to sing. Welcome to the choir. So today we celebrate God's love for us, which never ends. We celebrate the opportunity to welcome a new member into our family of church and to make our promises that we will do our part in helping him know about Jesus. Sorry, folks. Please move over. So as you have with your other children, Jean Marie, Wild, and Mac, Grant, Carrie, I'll ask you to reaffirm your promises again this morning on behalf of Dash. Do you reaffirm your faith in Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior? Do you? Do you claim God's covenant promises on Dash's behalf? And do you look in faith to the Lord Jesus Christ for his salvation just as you do for your own? Do you? Do you now promise in humble reliance upon God's grace to set before Dash an example of the new life in Christ? Do you?
We do.
Do you promise to pray with and for Dash and to bring him up in the knowledge and love of God? Do you?
We do.
Asking the questions of the congregation this morning is a man who has a vested interest in this and is looking for all the help he can get. He's a grandfather to these children, Mike Perkins.
Thank you. Do we, the members of this congregation, in the name of the whole Church of Christ, undertake with these parents the Christian nurture of this child so that in due time we may confess faith in Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior? Do we? Will we endeavor by our example and fellowship to strengthen Dash's ties with the household of God? Will we?
All right, boys and girls. Will you promise today to do everything you can to help Dash feel like a part of our church family and know what it means to be a part of the love of Jesus Christ? If you will, please say, I will.
I will.
Good job. Thank you. Let's pray together. God, we thank you for the sacrament of baptism and for its significance for us and for our church. We thank you for this family and for blessing them with Dash. We ask your rich blessing upon him. We ask that you'll bless all of us in the promises that we have just made to you and that you'll strengthen us to be faithful to those promises. Now we ask that you'll set aside this common element of water for a very sacred purpose, that it will symbolize for us the cleansing love of Jesus Christ for this child and for all of us. In your name we pray. Amen. The child's full name.
Dashiell Grant Small.
Dashiell Grant Small, child of the covenant, I baptize you in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's pray. To God, we pray that you will always surround Dash with your loving protection and care, that he'll never know a time when he's not aware of your love in his life. Thank you for surrounding him with a wonderful, loving family. We ask your blessing upon all of them as they serve their important roles in his life. We thank you for surrounding us all with a wonderful church family, and we ask that you use us all to care for each other and to love each other and nurture each other, especially this day, this child. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you very much. All right, boys and girls, if you're going to children's church, you can go now. Otherwise, back to your seats. Congregation, I invite everyone to sign the baptismal book, which is in the narthex today, as witness to this occasion. We will remain seated as we sing hymn 482, Baptized in Water.
Thank you.
Now, would you please join me for the prayer of illumination? Almighty God, you have spoken to us through your Son. Let your written word now be spoken and heard by each of us. Give us ears to hear and hearts to understand, that we may not refuse your calling or ignore your voice. May we all be taught by you through power and word. Amen.
Thank you. The scripture reading for this morning is found on page 62 in the New Testament section of your pew Bible, if you would like to follow along. Familiar story from Luke chapter 5, verses 1 through 11. Once while Jesus was standing beside the lake of Gennesaret, frequently known to us, this is the Sea of Galilee, and the crowd was pressing in on him to hear the word of God, he saw two boats there at the shore of the lake. The fishermen had gone out of them and were washing their nets. He got into one of the boats, the one belonging to Simon, and asked him to put out a little way from the shore. Then he sat down and taught the crowds from the boat. When he had finished speaking, he said to Simon, "Put out into the deep water and let down your nets for a catch." Simon answered, "Master, we've worked all night long but have caught nothing. Yet if you say so, I will let down the nets." When they had done this, they caught so many fish that their nets were beginning to break.
So they signaled their partners in the other boat to come and help them, and they came and filled both boats so that they began to sink. But when Simon Peter saw it, he fell down at Jesus' knees, saying, "Go away from me, Lord, for I am a sinful man." For he and all who were with him were amazed at the catch of fish that they had taken. And so also were James and John, sons of Zebedee, who were partners with Simon. Then Jesus said to Simon, "Do not be afraid. From now on you will be catching people." When they had brought their boats to shore, they left everything and followed him. Some of the greatest stories I've heard involve fishing. A few of them even involve fish, though many of the funniest ones do not. There are some days when anybody can catch a fish. You just put bait on the hook and throw it out and a fish will bite. There are other days when even the best fisher folk cannot catch a fish for one reason or another. And then there are days when it is possible, but you have to use your skill and knowledge and wit to catch them. Everybody dreams of catching the big one day, the one that usually gets away, the one that will form the heart of a great story for the rest of their lives. Today's Bible story is a fishing story, which has a number of different elements to it. It takes place early in the ministry of Jesus alongside the Sea of Galilee at a small fishing village called Capernaum, which became Jesus' home base while he was in the Galilee region. After our story from last week, in which Jesus was run out of his hometown of Nazareth, Jesus came to Capernaum and took residence there. He taught in the synagogue on the Sabbath and he performed healings, including healing Simon's mother-in-law. He moved around to other towns in the Galilee region, teaching in the synagogues and healing the sick, and he developed quite a following. Luke, who was not a disciple of Jesus who followed him around during his lifetime, has inherited a slightly different version of these early days and of the call of the first disciples than the other gospel writers. Matthew and Mark both portray a rather instantaneous call and response situation in which Jesus is walking alongside the Sea of Galilee and he sees the fishermen out in their boats and he calls to them to follow him and they immediately leave their nets and follow him. Luke's story gives us more detail and background about why those disciples followed Jesus. Luke tells us that on this particular day, there were many people crowding around Jesus to hear him teach. He needed some separation from the crowd in order to teach effectively. He saw two boats which were not being used because the fishermen to whom they belonged had stepped out of their boats and were washing their nets, which meant they were through for the day. Jesus stepped into one of those boats and he asked the owner, Simon, to take him out a little ways from the shore where he could sit down and teach the crowds. So Jesus had this throng of people following him around who were already hooked, who were following him and hanging on every word he said. And then he had these fishermen who were busy with their work. It was going to take some knowledge and some skill to bring them into the boat. So he immediately gave one of them a job, the job of taking him out a ways from the shore in a boat. My father was an avid fisherman. He liked to joke that the good thing about fishing was that he would have a captive audience for a few hours. I was that audience a few times. I didn't turn out to like fishing much. Well, Jesus turned Simon into a captive audience that day as they sat in the boat together while Jesus taught the crowd. And when Jesus had finished teaching the crowd, he turned his attention to Simon. He told him to put the boat out into the deep water and put the nets down for a catch. Simon wasn't eager to do that. He'd already put in a long day. He'd already washed out his nets and made ready for going out the next night. He said, "Master, we worked all night long and we didn't catch anything." Nevertheless, though he was tired, hungry, ready to go home, he did what Jesus asked him to do. He was skeptical about the possibility of catching fish at this time of day, but he had seen and heard enough of Jesus that he was willing to make the effort and see what happened. After all, in the preceding chapter, we saw Jesus healing Simon's mother-in-law. So Simon took the boat out into deeper water and let his nets down, and immediately the nets were so loaded with fish that they began breaking. He called to his partners on the shore, and they quickly brought the other boat to help land the catch, and soon both boats were so filled with fish that they began to sink. Simon's response is eye-opening and not what I would expect. I think he'd be jumping up and down, laughing, hugging Jesus, thinking about how he was going to market all these fish and wondering how he could get Jesus to sign on the dotted line to be his new partner. But instead, he falls on his knees before Jesus and exclaims, "Go away from me, because I'm a sinful man." Fishing was his job. This was his lake. He knew this catch didn't just happen. Leonard Sweet explains it well, saying, "Simon Peter suddenly realizes that he's not just standing in the middle of two boatloads of fish. He's standing in the middle of a God moment, a divine miracle. With just a word, Jesus had made these fishers more successful than they had ever dreamed possible. But Simon Peter didn't feel like a winner. Instead, he was overcome by his own human sinfulness and inadequacy. In despair, Simon Peter collapses at Jesus' knees. As economic security flips and flops about his feet, Simon Peter next hears from Jesus the words that will truly transform his life. It's a message that completely rejects the miracle of wealth that fills the boats. Jesus calls Simon Peter away from a life and lifestyle that has just now grown immensely richer and easier. "Leave off catching fish," Jesus calls. "From now on, you'll be catching people." And this simple fisherman and his companions are so moved by the Spirit of Jesus and the power of his presence that they take a truly stunning course of action. Hauling the loaded boats ashore, these fishermen abandon their new wealth and leave behind their old symbols of security. The Bible says they left everything and followed him. It was one thing for Simon to see Jesus heal his mother-in-law. I guess there could have been coincidence in that. She might have already turned the corner. Her fever might have been about to break one way or the other. There was a lot that Simon didn't know about sickness. But to experience this miracle at work was a different matter altogether. I'm sure Simon thought there wasn't anything he didn't know about fishing, and he thought he knew that this could not happen. Seeing it happen shattered any doubts he might have had about Jesus. It made him realize there was a lot about the world that he didn't know. It shattered his understanding of what the future held for him to the point that he left the huge catch and his boats and his old life in order to follow Jesus into the future that this extraordinary individual was going to usher in. When I went off to college, I assumed I would get an education and then go back home and get a job and live pretty much the way I always have. While I was at college, a president was impeached, the Arab oil embargo caused gas shortages and utility shutdowns, and there were a variety of other national and international crises. So much was called into question regarding my assumptions about the world and my place in it. And while confidence in everything else was eroding for me, what found its way to the top was this guy who walked around doing good, being kind, and offering hope to everyone. And that began a journey for me from viewing Jesus as an interesting part of my life to being the central figure in my life. I doubt that makes much sense to you, although the swirl of inauguration events, protests, and marches this weekend may signal a similar period in history. Simon Peter's response to the things that happened in the boat that day didn't make much sense either. Maybe that's why Matthew and Mark just said Jesus walked by and called the fishermen to follow, and they did. Ah, who would have believed it if we'd told it, they might have thought. Our ears and our eyes can reveal to us that nets are breaking, but the breaking of other things that happens inside us is not visible. It's not explainable. Maybe you've experienced a time like this in your life, a time when everything you were so sure of no longer seemed certain, when the goals you were working toward were exposed like the mighty Wizard of Oz with the curtain flung back, a time when the future seemed terribly unfocused and uncertain. If you've not yet experienced such a time, you probably will. And if so, view that as a time of great possibility as well as of great uncertainty. Do not be afraid. Pay attention to what goes on inside you as well as outside. It may be that the one who walks by the seashore of our lives is reaching out to you and is in some way calling you to fish for something different in your life, calling you to walk with him and learn from him in humility and obedience and gratitude. The hymn we're going to sing in a minute is beautiful in its simplicity. It strips away all the stuff that clutters up our lives and our thoughts and gets to the very core of Christian discipleship. You've come up to the lake shore looking neither for wise nor for wealthy. You only wanted that I should follow. O Lord, with your eyes you've searched me, and while smiling you've called out my name. Now my boat's left on the shoreline behind me. Now with you I will seek other seas. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Statement of faith this morning is from the brief statement of faith, which is found in the front of your hymn book on pages 37 and 38 prior to the beginning of the hymns. Today we'll be using section 2, which begins after the first paragraph. So at this point I'd invite you to stand and join me in the affirmation of faith. We trust in Jesus Christ, fully human, fully God. Jesus proclaimed the reign of God, preaching good news to the poor and release to the captives, teaching by word and deed and blessing the children, healing the sick, binding up the brokenhearted, eating with outcasts, forgiving sinners, and calling all to repent and believe the gospel. Unjustly condemned for blasphemy and sedition, Jesus was crucified, suffering the depths of human pain and giving his life for the sins of the world. God raised this Jesus from the dead, vindicating his sinless life, breaking the power of sin and evil, delivering us from death to life eternal. Please join me in prayer. God, as we gather in your house this day and come to you in prayer, we come from many different places, many different experiences, many different emotions. This day we ask that you will be present with all of us, that you will teach us, that you will guide us, that you will encourage us. On this weekend, which begins a new era for our country, we offer our prayers for all those who have been elected and taken office. We particularly pray for President Trump and for his family. We pray for your safety for them. We pray for your guidance and direction and courage for him as he leads. Pray that you'll be with all others who have been elected to serve and those who are being appointed to serve in different roles, and ask that you will be present with each of them and use them for your work. Pray for our divided country continually. We ask that you will be with those who are of different opinions and perspectives, and ask that you will grant us wisdom and courage to choose our paths wisely, to choose them peacefully, to choose them in ways that will make a difference in the world. We ask that you'll be with all of those who are discouraged and be with all of those who are ecstatic today. And we ask that you'll help this congregation to continue to be a place where each can be welcomed and accepted and understood, that you will use us to teach the world that people can differ on issues and politics and social matters and be united in obedience to you and your Son, Jesus Christ, in service. We ask that you'll be with us for that exceedingly difficult task, that you will grant us your mercy and your peace as we work together. Pray this day for all who are sick, for all who are grieving, for all those who are struggling with circumstances of life, whether it be family issues or work, school, whatever the issues might be. We pray your strength and blessing for each person. We ask that you will continue to use us to lift each other up, to encourage each other, to inspire and sustain each other. We ask that you will help us to look to you in all things as the Lord of our lives and the Lord of the world. We ask these and all of our prayers in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior, who taught us to pray together, saying, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen." Now let us continue to worship God as stewards of what we have been given as we present God's tithes and our offerings to the Lord.
God, in all things we give you thanks. We are grateful to you for your many blessings in our lives, many ways in which you have gifted us. We ask that you use us as stewards of all those things as we enter into this new year. We ask your blessing upon these gifts that are presented today, that you'll use them for the work of your kingdom, and that you will use us in your service. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. I invite you to go forth from this place into the world in peace. Go in the power of the Holy Spirit, returning no one evil for evil, but only good. And may grace, mercy, and peace from God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit be and abide with us all from this day forward and forevermore. Amen.